As part of the extended Dayforce self-service offering, you may choose to have access to some additional HR screens. These include training, performance, HR policy submission, and HR incidents. Please note that in future releases, many of these areas will be enhanced and further expanded upon. There may or may not be additional costs associated with implementing the newly refurbished modules. Let's have a look at some of the information that can be contained within these specific tabs. Under training, we can see that Aaron has been enrolled in the store manager program. We can configure programs that have affiliated courses associated with them. If I click on the courses tab, we can see which courses are part of the store manager program and which additional courses Aaron might be enrolled in. As part of the store manager program, we can see that courses have already been assigned to Aaron. These include business admin, communication, managing people, and health and safety. We can also see that some of these courses have been started, with one being completed. There is an area indicating whether or not the candidate has passed or failed the particular course, if there's an expiry date for a certification, certification number, overall score, and comment. Additionally, you may add alternate courses, which the employee is also enrolled in. These can be easily accessed by clicking on the New button and then clicking on the drop-down box to select the applicable course. You can also track any specific skill levels an employee may have by utilizing the Skills tab. Under the Skills tab, you can configure the various skills you would like to track. You can also configure what constitutes the skill level and whether or not there is a start or end date associated with it. We can now look at some of the information that may be tracked within the Performance tab. Under the Performance tab, you can track any new performance review entries or review previous performance review information. This is a high-level overview of the performance review information. As you can see, it can track what performance cycle we are in, the overall performance rating, the rating score for the individual, who the reviewer was, the actual review date, and when the next review date is scheduled for. You also have access to a comment field in which you can provide additional details. The system will automatically store and continue to retain the information so that you can quickly access when the last review was held. Also within the reports library, there is a report for upcoming or 90-day performance reviews, which is completely date-driven. Let's have a look at HR incidents. With HR incidents, if assigned or provided the authority to enter and monitor HR incidents, managers can simply click on the New button to add any new incident type and also to review or update the status of any in-progress HR incident. As you can see, once you click New, you'll be asked to select from an incident type. It's going to open the file and you'll be asked to submit what action or what state we are currently in regards to this particular HR incident. We can also list any complainant that might be involved and who this has been assigned to for HR management. There is a notes field, and in this case we can see Aaron mistakenly traveled to Mexico with his BlackBerry, incurring a $1,200 bill. Finally, under HR policies, managers will be able to track which HR policies individual employees have signed off on and the date upon which they were signed off.